My name is Egon Bech Hansen, and I'm a professor in microbial food and feed ingredients at the Technical University of Denmark. And I have been the chairman of the organizing committee for this MiFFi conference.
And my name is Dennis Sandris Nielsen. I'm a professor in microbiology from the Department of Food Science here at University of Copenhagen, and I've had the pleasure of being part of the organizing committee for the MiFFi conference.
So we are here at the poster area, and I actually have with me two very key people in the organizing committee of this MiFFi conference, and I will ask them a few questions to get some insights on the organization and the outcomes that we're hoping to have here in these 3 days of lovely science. I will direct first to Egon the question. So what are some key outcomes that you wanted to achieve by organizing this conference?
The main idea behind the MiFFi conferences is to bring scientists working in industry, academia, and working with regulatory aspects in government institutions together to discuss about current evolutions and innovations in the food and feed ingredients industry. And I think we have seen in the first MiFFi conference that there was a need for this. We planned the second MiFFi conference to occur in the spring last year, but we had to cancel that due to the COVID-19. And we are now finally here executing the MiFFi 2, and it has been an enormous success. Mm-hmm. I would judge from the noise level in the lecture hall before starting and with the excellent talks and the abundance of engaged questions. Mm-hmm. So we enjoyed very much.
Yeah, and also Dennis, I don't know if you want to add anything on that, and also just commenting on, you know, the vibe of the whole conference as well.
Yeah, but this has been exactly as I hoped and as I remember from the last MiFFi conference, that the breaks are actually a little bit too short, because there are so many people that you want to talk to, and that's old colleagues and people that you have been collaborating with or want to collaborate with, and you can just feel that there's this vibe during the breaks where people are talking, and it is obvious that a lot of old connections are renewed and new connections are made.
Yeah, exactly. And I've noticed that during the breaks, there's also several industries that are here and exhibiting. And also they gave, we had, I think, three or four industry talks with very, very good content. So, you know, how did this come about? And did you think it was up to expectations?
I would say it was very much up to expectations. Also proving, we already knew that, but proving again that very good science is taking place also in industry, and that is not just selling things, but there's actually very good science behind. And I think us from academia could also learn something there on how they approach things and how they approach science.
Yeah, and Egon, I don't know if you have to add anything on the industry.
For a conference like this, it's very important that we have the support from industry. So we are also very pleased to see the sponsorships from the main sponsors and also from the long list of partners. It's not a surprise to me, because I worked in industry myself, but it has been a pleasure to see at this conference that the industry symposia, which has been organized by the industry, are very, very scientific also. And we have seen in the scientific sessions that also selected for presentations are scientists from industry. Mm. So I think this conference proves that there is a need for stimulating the exchange at high level and between academia and industry.
Yeah, and so what's next for the MiFFi conferences? Do you plan to have another one?
Dennis and I have, and with a lot of others during the conference, we have discussed that this is proving again that there's a need for MiFFi. So the second conference has felt like an enormous success for all of us participating. So we will definitely organize a third one and hopefully make it to a recurring event.
Yeah.
Dennis has promised to be the pillar in the next one. So I'm pretty sure it will be a success also.
We very much hope so, at least.
Yeah.
And I think we all look forward to start organizing the next version. The nice thing about organizing a conference is that you can make a wish list of all the excellent scientists where you would like to see a talk, and cool thing here is that most of them actually accepted, and despite Corona and restrictions, etc., were able to show up here in Denmark, and mm-hmm. it was just so nice to see people again and see them live on stage.
Yeah. So it's nice, you know, after this time we haven't done in-person conferences, it's just nice to get the passion from this. For me, it's really one of my first in-person conferences for quite a while, to take this passion and take all these networks that you've made also with industry to kind of organize the next and what's more to come and things like that.
It seemed very clear to me that the presenters have been very satisfied presenting to an audience and not to a screen. I think that has been pretty obvious in all sessions.
Yeah, and now I want to switch a little bit focus and discuss about the MiFFi thematic issue. So you're both guest editors of the issue that was recently published. So I just want to hear a few words, if you can tell us about the thematic issue itself.
Yes, one of the results from the conference would be that there would be scientific papers, reviews and commentaries, and we will publish that in a special issue of FEMS Microbiology Letters. We did that after the first MiFFi conference. That's already out in print and also accessible online. We completed a somewhat smaller special issue after the conference we didn't have. Mm-hmm. And we decided to close that issue just before we execute this conference, and then we will make a special issue based on the posters, the talks and presentations actually given here, and also invite scientists from the field which didn't make it to Copenhagen, that if they have papers within the field and scope of MiFFi, they can also contribute, even if they were not participating in person mm-hmm. here.
Mm-hmm. So you're having an open call, really, for everyone in the field to submit. Are there any deadlines associated with
the... Yes, the deadline for submitting the manuscript is April 1st, 2022.
Yeah.
And we expect to close the issue around September mm-hmm. 22.
Mm-hmm. And Dennis, do you have anything else to add about the upcoming or previous thematic issue?
Well, I think the first two thematic issues we have had have actually been really interesting to read. Also, I have, as the guest editor, read most papers before they were printed, and there's a lot of cool stuff between. And I look forward to see the third version here, where I expect to see mm-hmm. many cool papers based on what we have seen here at the conference.
Mm-hmm. Great, thank you so much. That was the last question that I had for today. Thanks so much for your time, and enjoy the little bit conference that's left. So
thanks a lot.